Another 2019 PSLE Math Tricky Question Answered. Hi everyone. Today we are going to discuss the 2019 PSLE Math Percentage Question that confused some Singaporean primary school kids. This question is mainly about two children buying some egg tarts. And after going through this practical math video, don't forget to try out more math questions on percentages on our website to see how well you have mastered the skills. Ready to solve the question? Let's start by reading this math problem sum together, alright? Jamie and Oliver used $61.20 each to buy some egg tarts. So looks like we have two people buying egg tarts here, Jamie and Oliver. And both of them spent the same amount of money, $61.20, to buy the egg tarts. What are we given next? Our lucky Jamie has a 15% discount coupon. So guess who gets to buy the egg tarts at a cheaper price? As a result of using the discount coupon, Jamie bought 6 more egg tarts than Oliver. This PSLE math question is divided into two parts. So let's solve part A of the question first. How many egg tarts did Jamie buy? So it seems like we are supposed to find the number of egg tarts that Jamie bought. Do you know how to go about finding the answer? Since there's a discount involved, let's think of the number of egg tarts each of them bought in terms of the percentage of the price, alright? Now, we know that Oliver used $61.20 to buy a number of egg tarts, correct? And he bought them without the discount. So this means that at 100% of the price, he could buy this number of egg tarts, okay? Then what about Jamie? Because Jamie had a 15% discount, we know that she spent 100% minus the 15% discount, which is 85% of $61.20, to buy the same number of eggs that Oliver bought. Although we don't really know how many egg tarts this is, we do know that Jamie was able to buy 6 more egg tarts than Oliver using the remaining 15% of $61.20. So far so good? Now, if 15% of $61.20 can buy Jamie 6 egg tarts, how many egg tarts can 100% of the money buy? Can you see that this is actually a simple problem of ratio? If we know the number of egg tarts that 15% of $61.20 can buy, we can actually move on to find out the number of egg tarts that 5% of that money can buy. And eventually, we can find the number of egg tarts that 100% of $61.20 can buy. Following so far? Let's work this out together, okay? How many egg tarts can we buy with 5% of the price? Since 15% of $61.20 can buy Jamie 6 egg tarts, to find the number of egg tarts that 5% of $61.20 can buy, what do? 15% divided by 3 gives us 5%, correct? So we'll divide the 6 egg tarts by 3 over here too. Do you get 2 egg tarts? Now that we know 5% of $61.20 can buy us 2 egg tarts, how many egg tarts can we buy with 100% of $61.20? To find the answer, let's just take 5% times 20 to give us 100% and multiply 2 egg tarts by 22. This should give us 40 egg tarts. And that is how we know that Jamie bought 40 egg tarts with $61.30. Congrats! You have just solved part A of this PSLE percentage question. Are you ready to solve the next part of the question? In part B of the question, we are supposed to find what is the cost of 1 egg tart without the discount. We have found earlier on in part A that Jamie used $61.20 to buy 40 egg tarts, correct? But remember that she bought the egg tarts at a 15% discount? So what does this mean? This means that Jamie only paid 85% of the full price for her 40 egg tarts. Now what if Jamie didn't have the discount? How much would she have paid for the 40 egg tarts? Let's work backwards, okay? If 85% of the full price for her 40 egg tarts is $61.20, this would mean that 1% of the full price would be $61.20 divided by 85, which is 72 cents. And since 1% of the full price is 72 cents, we can then calculate 100% of the original price of the 48 tarts, correct? We'll simply multiply 72 cents by 100. Do you manage to get $72? If you did, great job. Now that we know 48 tarts cost $72 without any discount, what can we do to find the cost of 1 egg tart? We'll divide $72 by 40, correct? And this gives us an answer of $1.80 for each egg tart without the discount. And with that, we have solved part B of this PSLE math percentage question. Yay! We hope you enjoyed this practical math video. If you want to stay updated of new math videos like this, don't forget to subscribe to this channel and turn on the notification bell beside it. Thank you for watching. Till next time, happy problem solving!